At the moment, I am working at the Finnish Meteorological Institute as a research scientist. My current research focuses on computational methods and peatland restoration. At Aalto University, I studied water and environmental engineering.
I studied real estate economics. Once I was a high school student, I had a really strong background in natural sciences. So real estate economics have very strong connection with the industry. This means that there are guest lectures and then of course multiple part-time opportunities, the way that I also got a job in our field to be a part-time worker there. I always wanted to be a businesswoman, and now when I have graduated from School of Engineering, I combine my passion to the fashion with the shopping center owners in the field of real estate. And as a doctoral student, I have opportunity to travel to capital of fashion, Milan, and continue working there with the real estate owners and take my studies further.
Before I started at Aalto, I heard a presentation about specifically geoinformatics and how they study laser scanning and 3D modeling and drone imagery, and those subjects were of interest to me, and that's why I also wanted to know, like, how can I get there, and chose this program. I chose the geoinformatics because environmental values are important to me. I like the fact that geoinformatics combines mathematics and visualization, so this creative side of me, and I can get the best of both worlds there.
I studied in the Aalto University the Spatial Planning and Transportation Engineering program. And after that, for about 5 years, I was in the VTT Research Institute. And now, about 1.5 years, I am in the HSL, which is the local transport authority.
I did my master's thesis in a research group here at Aalto University. It was a full-time paid position in a research group called Water Resource Management and Environmental Hydraulics. It was a really cool opportunity for me because I am interested in research in general and also like scientific process of creating knowledge. So it was a really cool thing that I got to do my thesis in such environment. I really enjoy my work at the moment. I have great colleagues and I get to work with topics that are important to me every day. So I think that's a very important aspect of my work. Something else that I have learned is that we actually understand very little of the future effects of climate change, especially on the ecosystem functioning. And this is a huge uncertainty when climate change is all the time progressing. And it's really motivational for me that I get to contribute to a better understanding of these issues and hopefully being able to solve some of them at least.
One memorable experience was when I was working in the guild called Guild of Serving Engineers. I was head of corporate relations. And when I went to job interview, I mentioned this as an experience. And my interviewer was saying, like, oh, she actually worked in the same guild once she was a student. And finally, I got the job.
I worked with VTT while doing my thesis, and the topic that we chose was about monitoring the revegetation of mine sites using optical satellite imagery. And the thesis was a good learning experience, and I got the chance to continue at VTT after the thesis was done, so I'm currently working there full-time.
I originally came through the Erasmus exchange studies program, and I figured out during this exchange that I could stay for the whole degree, and since I very much liked Finland, then I took all the steps that made it possible. As a kid, I already liked transportation quite much, both cars and public transportation, but my dream job was precisely maybe I wanted to like plan the public transport lines. But now I'm very close to it. I actually sit to the real planners next to me, but I actually changed a bit my definition of dream job. So I wanted to go more the transport modeling way, and I think I'm pretty much doing that dream job right now.
Initially, I chose the program of energy and environmental engineering because I wanted to work in the field of energy technology. But during the studies, I learned more about water and environmental related issues, and I found that they were super interesting because they intersect with several societal and environmental issues that we are currently facing. And I think in the future, this expertise will be even more needed in the society as the climate change progresses. And also thinking of like the possible careers that are ahead of me. I think this is a field that gives me unlimited number of options.
To the students who are now starting their careers, I would say that be active. There are several events such as workshops about topics that might interest you. For example, I myself participated in a winter satellite workshop. I just went there, told that I would be interested in doing my thesis at various companies that I knew, and I told them what topics would interest me and what skills I have. After those discussions, I got several business cards. I contacted the same people later, and that's how I got my current thesis topic and the work that I'm doing at the moment.